Joining me now for more on President Trump's tax announcement tomorrow, Club for Growth President David McIntosh. David, sometimes you and I have been at odds about Donald Trump and other things, but on this, I think we are in lockstep. We both believe in the power of tax cuts. I think the president believes in the power of tax cuts. He's seen how it incentivizes businesses and individuals in this country to an extent that a lot maybe of his advisors don't see it. Certainly the folks inside the Beltway don't, but he's plowing right through their objections, is he not?
He is. He's doing a wonderful job of leading on this. It was a key part of his campaign promises to the American people. And these are pro-growth tax cuts. It looks like they're going to take the corporate rate to 15%. I think when they also do that through on the small business tax rate as well, that will unleash millions in job creation. It will actually let the economy potentially grow at the 3.5% rate instead of the anemic 1% rate of the Obama years. And with that, you know, the green eyeshade people here in Washington say, oh my goodness, we're going to lose all this revenue. Well, history proves time and time again, when you have economic growth, you actually get more revenue in Washington because more people are making money and they can pay more taxes.
It was twice as much during the Reagan administration. Reagan came into power. I think the tax rates, the top rate was at 70%. He eventually brought it down to about 28%. Yeah. And during that time, when the tax rates were more than cut in half, revenues doubled, right?
That's right. They doubled. Nobody expected it. Of course, Congress at that time spent even more than that. Right. So our mantra is if you want to have pro-growth, cut taxes. If you're worried about the debt, cut spending. But the tax cuts we need for that pro-growth stimulus that everybody is expecting. You see, the markets reacted today just in anticipation of the president's announcement.
And, you know, yesterday, some people, in fact, we're going to talk to somebody later on in the program who says it was because of France. I will buy that for yesterday. But today, for another 1% move in the plus side for the markets, I think that was all about taxes, don't you?
I do. I think it was clear that was the agenda of the day. And one of the things the president and the Secretary of Treasury and all of his people have said is we're not going to be bound by this. We have to raise another tax when we cut one tax. That just pits one group against another. They're saying we're going to have an aggressive rate tax cut, and that will create growth, and that will take care of the revenue needs.
David, stay with us. I want to bring in Tax Foundation economist Alan Cole with us because, Alan, it's not only the green eyeshade folks who are against or at least pushing against the idea of tax cuts. It's also the lobbyists, all those K Street lobbyists, the swamp, if you will, the swamp creatures that have spent years and millions of dollars getting their special cutouts in tax bills. They don't want change, do they?
No, and often that's one of the trickiest parts, getting some of the unnecessary deductions and credits out of the tax code in order to pay for lower rates for everyone.
Well, and that's why I'm holding in my hand the postcard tax form that was actually outlined in a tax plan that came out last summer by the GOP. And there are only 14 lines on this postcard tax form. Is there any chance that we would be able to get rid of so many of the deductions that we could put our tax returns on one postcard?
That's kind of an ambitious and lofty goal. There's definitely stuff that you can do for simplicity.
Yeah.
But remember that people care about things like, you know, how many children they have and getting deductions for dependents and that kind of thing. So it's always going to be, you know, some length.
Well, on this postcard, David, you have deductions for savings plans, mortgage interest deduction, charitable contribution, a child credit deduction, earned income tax credit, and higher education credit. That's it. Is that enough?
That sounds very good to me. The flatter you get the tax cut, get rid of all of those special interest deductions and lower the rates. That will be good for everybody. And what's tough to do is to sell to the K Street lobbyists, look, your clients will actually be better off when we lower the overall rate, especially for corporate America, but also for individuals. And yes, you're going to give up a little bit of a benefit that you've lobbied for over all these years, but in the end, they will be better off when it's an even playing field.
Yeah.
Among other things, you don't get the distortion of decisions by business, where do we invest?
Right.
There's no reason you should have your CFO sitting in the boardroom saying, you can't make that good investment. It's not as good a tax deal as a different one.
Well, and you bring up a great point, because there's so much wasted energy. If we all were able to do just a postcard for our taxes, we wouldn't be spending literally billions. People have put it together. There are, I think, a couple of billion man hours put into filling out taxes every year, not just individuals, but the whole, all the tax attorneys and everything else. All that wasted energy and time could be spent on improving the economy. The economy would be the biggest beneficiary of this kind of tax change. Guys, we got to leave it at that. Alan and David, thank you very much.